Bismillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulillah. This is a quick analysis of Surah Naba, which is Surah number 78, and this is the beginning of the 30th Juz. This Surah, subhanAllah, I read something from Mulana Ahmad Ali Lahori on the tafsir of this, and it had baffled me sometime why Allah had mentioned something at the beginning and then He suddenly moves on to something else, and what the link is from this second part of the first part. But after reading his tafsir, it's very clear and it's quite striking as well. So in the beginning, Allah mentions that people are talking about the Day of Judgment and they in doubt about the Day of Judgment. And then Allah says, did I not make the earth for you a place that is for you to lie upon? In ayah number 6, then وَالْجِبَالَ أَوْتَادَ, I made the mountains pegs, وَخَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَزْوَاجَ, and I created you as spouses, and then I gave you sleep, something that gives you rest. And I made the night something that it covers you, and I made the day that is a form of livelihood for you, and I made above you 7 strong layers, and then I gave you a shining and bright sun, and I revealed from the skies plenty of water, and from that I bring out seed or grains and vegetation, and I create for you wonderful and luxurious gardens. And then suddenly, this is in at the end of ayah number 16. So in ayah number 17, Allah says, surely the day of making a decision is our meeting, or the day of reaping the seed and the harvest is the day of meeting. Now, why would Allah mention it like that? Why would Allah suddenly come to the Day of Judgment when He's mentioned all these other things around us in this world? So to explain this, Mawlana Ahmad al-Lahori, he says that a farmer who puts his seed into the ground, he will put into the soil. He needs the soil, he needs the compost, he needs the rainwater, he needs the sun and so on. But after he has had many months, he will come one day, he will cut his cultivation, he will cut it down to the bottom, to the stalk. Of the stalk, and he will take away his harvest. He will not be too concerned about the sun or the rain or other things at that time. He just simply wants to take his harvest and move on. So Mawlana Ahmad al-Lahori, in his Quran Aziz, what he explains is Allah has created for us the earth, mountains, spouses, sleep, night, day, layers on top of us of the sky, and the sun, rain, seeds, grains, vegetation, and He's given us gardens. After all of this, He's not interested except in two things. One is the human being, and of the human being, He wants his actions. So just as the farmer will discard everything else, even the stalk that he's got, he'll throw it away. He just wants to have the grains and the seeds and the wheat and whatever else is on that. And he wants to take out of there the actual rise or the actual benefit for himself and for him to sell on. He won't care about the stalk or the earth or anything else behind. Same way, Allah will not bother about our sleep. He will not bother about the night, the day, the sun, the moon, or other things that are around us. All of this has been subjugated to us so that we can produce actions on the Day of Judgment. So that's why Allah links all of this to the Day of Judgment by saying, "Inna yawmul fasli kana miqata." When the Day of Judgment comes, I'm going to have you, the human being, write down, coming here with your actions. And that's the only thing I'm interested in. I'm not interested in anything else. All the material gains, all the wealth, the relationships you had, the houses you stayed in, nothing I'm interested in. I'm going to destroy all of that. And the only thing I'm interested in is in what you actually bring forth on the day. I want to see your actions. SubhanAllah al-Azim, very, very profound tafsir. And then, you know, the Quran moves on to say, يَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ, the day when the horn will be blown, and all of you will come in troops, and you know, the skies will open, the mountains will sail across the sky, and so on and so forth. But it's a very profound part of how Mawlana Ahmad al-Lahori has connected this part of ayah number 17 with the rest of the surah before it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.